So today we are going to be talking about Ali Hazelwood's stance of love theories. I read the love hypothesis and love theoretically on my Kindle, and I read love on the brain physical because I have a book of the month month subscription, which we'll get to that spiel in a second. In the love hypothesis, there was sort of a faculty student and like grad student sort of scenario, which I feel like that's taboo personally. Like, probably not faculty student, but like faculty member. I feel like anything that's faculty and just like students in general across the board is taboo to me. I just find that, yeah, just that makes me uncomfortable. There's Smut, which I don't know how well Smut can be written, but it's there, and definitely, like, I feel like it's written in a respectful sort of manner. And also, in this book, there's a character named Tom Benton, who you think is a good guy, but quickly turns out to be an asshole, and I quickly want to punch him in the face. Because he says horrendous things to Olive, which, by the way, Olive had like some sort of like speech thing, so she was like recording it for like one of the professors, which is very nice. Like, I knew when Tom Benton was saying this and it was recorded, I was like, you're recording this, you can like do something about it. But no, see, that's not get recognized till like later chapters. I'm just like, are you this dumb? How are you a STEM student and like that slips your mind? Like, trauma? Maybe. Trauma? That probably makes sense. But also, I feel like your phone was recording, you clicked to stop the recording, how does your brain not be like... So yeah, Adam, who is a sort of faculty member basically, finds out about what Tom said and basically threatens to punch him and kick his ass, which... I agree. Just... Yeah. And also, what is it with men and growling? Like, am I the only one who doesn't understand that? Like, I'm weirded out by it. Like, it's there, okay, but also, why? And just, yeah, Adam's minor POV is just... Like, listen, I love when I get the whole, like, female perspective, but, like, the men's POV, like, where we see them fall for, like, female love interest or just love interest in general. That has me by the balls. I shouldn't have said that because I don't have an anatomy, but also, it has me in a chokehold. There we go. On to the second book, which is Love on the Brain and My Spiel, which you all probably hear me for. So yeah, Love on the Brain is Ali Hazelwood's second book in the series, and it's part of my Book of the Month subscription, which... If you just subscribe to Book of the Month, they recommend 5 books they think you might like, and you can get it in physical or audiobook, some of them, which I've been doing and I've been personally enjoying. Like, I, as a graphic design major, audiobooks are more helpful than physical to me, I'm realizing, so, yeah. But this is, in this book, there are just a lot of misunderstandings that I just feel like could be better addressed and better explained. Like, so the main male interest is not married. Okay, that could be better specified. Like, yeah, like, what is it with men just being weird in careers? Like, we just want, like, listen, I cannot speak for all women, but I can speak for myself. We just want to do what the fuck we need to do and fucking leave. We don't want whatever bullshit this is. Like, also, I knew, so... B, who is the female love interest, this would be her nickname. Transformers fans, don't give me that look, it's not the same. But yeah, B and Levi, I kind of knew that Schmac was Levi in the trade comments. I kind of knew, I was like, this is gonna be Levi, I can feel it. It's way too predictable, like... I like the comfort and the predictability in all this, but also I feel like it could have been not predictable as well. Like, Like, I knew it was, I knew Smut was Levi. I was like, yeah, this is not, things line up way too well. But like, yeah. And also, the trope in this series so far where, oh, the person you think is good is also like the villain, like, it's predictable, I hate it, but also, like, it's like, I get it, it's a comfort that it's predictable, but also I wish it wasn't, like, predictable, I wish it was, like, not that, because, like, in every book, it's just, so, in these two books, it's just, like, yeah, someone's a bad guy, clearly, but it's just who, that's the unpredictable part, and annoys me, yeah. So the last book is the Love Theoretically, which I always mess up, by the way. Which, yeah. Okay, so Love, my thoughts about Love Theoretically are just pretty similar to my thoughts about the other book, so I'm not even gonna bother. But the Olive Easter egg, when that scene happened, I was just like in my seat going, like, I was on my couch just going, trying to, like, not to kick and, like, be a child. But I was just like, yes, then, yeah, like, I know it was in the office note in the beginning, I feel like, but also, I'm happy that the scene's actually there. Oh my god. When Elsie goes, oh, I doubt Olive knows anything about fake dating, I was just in my seat going, if only you knew, like, I get why authors like that, but also, that stuff has me in my seat, like, seething, and so I was just like, she literally knows how to fake dating, yes, she was in a similar position as you. God damn it. But yeah, I don't remember this character's name, but I'm not going to look it up because the character's an asshole in this book. But yeah, when Zach threatened him, I was just like, yeah, and when Zach took responsibility, like, I was just like, finally, you did the right thing. It's the bare minimum. Damn it. But yeah, I feel a lot of sort of Elsie's feelings. Like, if I was in her position, I'd react a lot the same way. Like, I wouldn't want to, like, talk to people either. Like, if I was, like, up for a job only to find out that someone else got in, like, and someone else is getting it the entire time, like, I wouldn't be, like, happy at all either. So, like, yeah. Also, what is it with all of these men just in this consistent series being described as hot? Like, I've been in, as a person who goes to college, the chances of that are not that high. yeah. I enjoyed this series. I spent two whole days reading this book. As in two Saturdays. Like, that's all I did on my Saturdays. Like, two of them, and like, yeah, it was great. Like, can you tell I had a good time? Can you tell? But yeah, like, this is my last book of the month book for a little while, unless Britney Spears is there, which I did not check. Like, if there's, like, I'll probably look into memoirs and stuff, and I'll probably do that, but, like, I'm not going to, like, do the whole, like, in the book thing unless I know I have the space, basically, if that makes any sense. So, yeah. Thank you all for watching. I know I probably don't look like it, but I've been excited to, like, basically talk about the series because it's not my to be read list for a while, and a lot of people were talking about it just on social media, and just, yeah. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in my first audiobook book of the month video, which will be in the new year. So bye.